Good morning, student. This is the chapter of class 7th, heat. We have already done two videos related to this chapter. In the last video, we had learned laboratory thermometer. In this chapter, we will learn clinical thermometer and their uses. Clinical thermometer is mainly used in our room or doctor's clinic to measurement of body heat. So, their care and their how to use and their precaution is related to the clinical thermometer. Let's see. It is smaller in size with the temperature range from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. This is used for measuring human body temperature. The normal human body temperature is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. This is the remembering point. A clinical thermometer consists of narrow glass capillary. It has a bulb at one end and is scaled at the another end. A thermometer rises in the mercury. Mercury is used in clinical thermometer. So it is rising or expands. Mercury expands and moves up to show the temperature against the printed scale. How to use clinical thermometer? First, should be washed perfectly with on the antiseptic solution and dried using a cotton to swab it. The jerk will bring the lever of mercury below 35 degrees Celsius. Next one is, now place the bulb on the thermometer under your tongue. Under tongue to measuring the temperature of the body for about 2 minutes. 2 minutes is the maximum time to conduct the heat of the body temperature. Take the chosen scale. Is called its temperature. So some precautions are used to use a clinical thermometer. Let's see the precautions. Wash the thermometer before use or after. Next is, handle with care, prevent breakage. It should be breakage if you can't hold it carefully. Make sure the mercury level is below 35 degrees Celsius. So judge the temperature. Let's see the work of clinical thermometer. Differentiate with your work is the laboratory thermometer. In the last video we will learn laboratory thermometer. In this video we have talked and learned about clinical thermometer. So your work is to differentiate between clinical and laboratory thermometer. And second work is similarities between clinical and laboratory thermometer. This is the homework to you. Let's see transfer of heat. How can heat is transferred? Heat flow from higher temperature to lower temperature. Always heat is flowing. When heat is high flame, then it goes on low temperature. This is occur when the both body have equal temperature. When two body is in the equal temperature, it should be flow or low temperature. There are three different ways in which heat can be transferred from a body to another. Let's see the conditions to transfer of heat. This is the process by which heat transfer through one molecule to another molecule, just like a iron. When iron some tip is hot, the whole body become hot because of molecule. Some tiny part of molecule became hot, so all body is hot. So this is the process of condition to transfer of heat from the hot to the cold air. Condition for the conduction of heat. Heat can be conducted. All but everybody knows that the heat is conducted. conducted. So the some conditions are used. Let's see the condition. Heat can be conducted from one body to another body if they are in contact with each other. When two bodies contact with each other, heat can be transferred. As for example, take a one person who is falling ill with fever, and one person is the normal temperature. When they are come with each other and contact with each other, heat is transferred to one body to another body. Next one is all at different temperature. When the temperature is different, heat can be conducted. Let's see the good or bad conductor of heat. Good or bad conductor. Some materials is good conductor for heat and some are bad conductor for heat. As for copper, silver is the good conductor. Glass, air, rubber, this is a bad conductor. So let's see what happening in good or bad conductor of heat. Materials which conduct heat rapidly are good conductors, which is without any problem it flow the heat rapidly. So this is the good conductor. The material which do not conduct heat rapidly, something is dropping the flowness of heat, so it can't flow the rapidly heat to the one part to another part. So this is the bad conductor of heat. Let's see the example of good conductor. Good conductor, copper, iron, steel, silver. This is the good conductor of heat. And bad conductor, glass, air, plastic, rubber, wood. This is the bad conductor of heat. Uses of good conductor. Something is used for good conductor, and bad conductor is also used for our daily life, daily routines. So let's see the good conductor of heat. Cooking utensils are made from good conductors. Heat is very important in our life. So when we cook something, some pots are used in the making some foods. So good conductors are used in the making some body parts of the pots. Bodies are made by copper. Boiler are made by copper because a high temperature of heat is need to boil the something just like oil, water. So boiler is also made by copper. Mercury is used in thermometer. Mercury is also a good conductor of heat. So mercury is used in the thermometer to up, down and flowing the conduction of heat. Next one is cooling coil of refrigerator. Cooling coil, it's copper. Copper is the cooling coil which is used in our refrigerator. Let's see the bad conductor of heat. Wood is used to hold the object when it hot. When some body parts of the pot is hot, there another part is made by wood. Handle, there something parts is made by wood to take it to hold, and another part to use is made by good conductor. Next, so dustbin, a bad conductor of heat, is used to cover ice blocks. Third, ice box refrigerator has inner lining of glass wood, which is very poor conductor of heat. So this is used in refrigerator. The next topic is convection. And your work is read this carefully and do your homework. Thank you.